We are back with our Home on the Ranch tour. We have covered the exterior, the library, mudroom, basketball room, kitchen, great room, and now I'm going to take you down this gorgeous arched hallway to the primary bedroom. We found a 32-foot vintage runner that runs the length of the hallway that stretches essentially all the way across the great room and directs you towards the primary bedroom. In this space, we had vaulted ceilings, we did a white shiplap and beams, then we did a painted white brick and a really traditional mantel surround. I love that it has a lot of texture, it feels cozy and traditional, and then we kept all of the furnishings very simple and clean and serene. We did a wingback headboard. We actually originally planned to do a canopy bed here, and our client was like, he's really tall, and he was like, no, thank you, I'm not gonna do the canopy bed. So we did a wingback, and I still love how it really just keeps the space calm and allows you to look up and see the really gorgeous Ralph Lauren light fixture on the ceiling. We did a lot of mix of textiles on the bed, really textural layers. We had room for a full day bed at the foot of the bed. When you look at the headboard wall, we did sconces on either side. And one of my favorite things to do when we wire for sconces is incorporate a little piece of artwork, either leaned or hang something. It feels like a designer detail that isn't obvious, and it just takes the design up a notch. We really wanted everything to feel very, very calm. Our clients have a lot of kids, and this just needs to be a space where they can chill out. We have a lot of whites, cool blues. We wanted to warm up the space with some light wood oak details to kind of tie in the floors. We did that with our Alma chair and ottoman from McGee & Co., as well as the dresser that has this really great curved detail and a huge round mirror to just reflect all the light coming in through the French doors. And that whole wall takes you into their bathroom. We did a putty gray on the cabinetry, incorporated a mix of polished nickel and brass, and we have a porcelain Calcutta marble on the floors. When you do a steam shower, we try to avoid a natural stone because it's so porous. And so we did a porcelain that looks so close to the real thing. It looks so beautiful. And then I think the best detail in this space is the wall treatment that we did. We knew we didn't have a window behind the tub, which we often do, and then that creates the focal moment behind the tub. Instead, we did a wall treatment where we brought the tile up the walls, and then we seamlessly tied in the vertical shiplap. We did this really cool light fixture above the tub, and I love the way it turned out. Wraps up the primary bedroom and bathroom. You can see photos on our blog. You can shop a lot of the products that you've seen on McGee & Co. and check out our episode featuring this home on our Netflix series, Dream Home Makeover.